No problem. Yeah, hi. Imagine you're running an application or you're responsible for its operation, and suddenly something isn't going quite as planned. Something goes wrong, and you have to provide details about it. In case you have own applications, you can extend them by providing or by getting the required data. But what about applications you have purchased which you cannot extend and which isn't delivering the data you need? My name is Marius, and in this talk, I want to show you how you can extract arbitrary data from your Java applications by injecting OpenTelemetry bytecode and doing this even at runtime. So, starting with a small scenario. So, assuming you have a Java application, and some persons are coming to you and asking questions. For example, hey, is your application working? Or how many errors occur? Or what is the memory footprint of it? Or how long does it take in order to process a certain job or task? And yeah, how it's done. In order to answer these questions, you need data. For example, how long does it take to process a certain task? So assuming you have some Java class like this one, which providing quotes, so you can buy something, and you get a question, hey, how long does it take to provide a quote if you request a car? In order to provide or to answer this question, what you can do, you can measure it. So you can, in your application, add some code, for example, to capture some start timestamps, end timestamps, processing them, calculating a duration, and store this information. Maybe you add some context information, for example, is it a quote about a car or maybe a bike? And yeah, save this in some database or just logging it. And using this information, then you can say, okay, in order to provide a quote for a car, my application takes around 215 milliseconds. Now, if you went to your developers and say, okay, now put this code in all of our applications, maybe new questions arise. For example, are you serious? I have to touch all our existing legacy systems. Or, okay, I can do this, but how is it? How is the consistency between our teams? Are we doing all the same? Or is now every team implementing its own stuff? So do we get a consistent code base here in the end? Or another question, okay, now we have this in there, but how can we get this data which we are extracting here in our analyzing tools? All of these questions in the previous talk by Philip, we also already heard a lot about OpenTelemetry, and that's a quite good solution to tackle this problem. So for all of you who didn't attend the previous talk, what is OpenTelemetry? When we check out the OpenTelemetry website, they state OpenTelemetry is a collection of tools, APIs, SDKs, in order to collect and export telemetry data. What is telemetry data? Metrics, logs, and traces. So what is OpenTelemetry providing for us? OpenTelemetry provides a specific standard how telemetry data can be collected and how they have to be structured. So we get a consistent data format across our applications. Another benefit is that we are able to correlate these data to another. We have consistent IDs in our environment so that we can correlate data from different applications together, that we know, okay, an error in application B relates maybe to an error in application A. Further benefit, due to this standard data structure, we can use a lot of existing tools out there. So around the OpenTelemetry project, a lot of tools arise which are able to process, receive, store, and do really awesome stuff with the data which we are collecting. So if we go back to our Java application, we don't have to implement now some custom stuff, for example, to record or to measure response times. We can now use the OpenTelemetry, which can be used to record telemetry data, export it, and can then use, like I said, pre-existing tools without, with the help of OpenTelemetry. So how is this working now? Like I said, Java, we can now use OpenTelemetry API. So when we want to add, or when we use OpenTelemetry, we are developing against an API which has been specified by OpenTelemetry and which we can use in our libraries and the application and so on. So we are only developing against an API and don't provide the actual implementation of it. For example, if we provide just a library, we don't ship the implementation of this API. This implementation, the OpenTelemetry SDK, is then provided by runtime by the application. So this is separated from the API and can be exchanged. For example, it can be upgraded to a newer version, or maybe we have some different needs why we want to exchange this. And this SDK provides the implementation for its core functionality. For example, collecting data, processing it, but it doesn't provide, for example, exporting the data. So the data is collected by the SDK, and then we have this components, extension, and exporters, which are actually the connection to external tools. For example, we can use exporters to export the data to Elastic or to Jaeger or do different stuff with it. So this is quite nice because it's modular and we can only use the components which we need for our use case. So when we go back to the initial example, for example, we want to measure this Java class which I showed you earlier. We want to trace it now. We don't have to add custom code to for example, measure the time which this method needs to be done, but we can use OpenTelemetry now. So using the API, we can, for example, create spans. A span is basically a block of work, more or less. The span can be started, and we can also add arbitrary data to it. For example, something about a context. Like I did here, we add here to the span attribute called quote subject and add this subject to it so we know later on when we show this data what was the context, what was the execution context of this span. And in the end, we have to end the span so that we measure the time from start to end. And using this end, the span is also marked. Now it is done and it can be exported to our tracing backend, whatever it is. But we are not done yet. Actually, we are at the state of the initial example. So we measure, for example, how long this took, has some context information. But what's also awesome about OpenTelemetry is something called context propagation. Like earlier, for example, we measure this method, its runtime, storing some context information. But using this context propagation, we can now correlate different spans to each other. So, for example, if we record or collect more spans inside this call tree, for example, in our validate method, maybe there's another span recorded. Using this context propagator, these spans are correlated to each other. So we can see, okay, this span recorded in this validate method is related to the current one here. But as you obviously see, in order to do this change, we have to adapt our code base. So we need the ability to touch the code base and to extend it. But there are a lot of situations where this is not possible. For example, if we have a purchased application where we can manually add this to our code base, or maybe we don't want to do it because we have so many places to add this manually and we want to do it in an automatic fashion. For this purpose, OpenTelemetry provides something called a Java agent, the OpenTelemetry Java agent. This can be used that this manually injected monitoring code, which I showed you in the slide before, can be added to your applications automatically during runtime without touching the code base. And this is done by the so-called Java application using something called bytecode instrumentation. And what's this? Actually, this Java agent is attached to your JVM that's done, for example, at startup via a JVM command or can be done at runtime. And then it takes these original classes and sprinkles some magic about around it and adds this code which we have injected earlier. So the result is the same. Our class has this OpenTelemetry bytecode inside it. It's collecting the data, exporting it using the OpenTelemetry exporter, which are now shipped using our Java agent, and we get insight into our application without touching the initial source code. The OpenTelemetry Java agent provides here a really good insight on popular tools, libraries, and frameworks. So, for example, if you use a JDBC interface, you get now all JDBC calls or HTTP calls and so on. But what you don't get is the ability that you can extract data of your custom application classes. So if you have, for example, certain functionality which you are interested in, which you want to monitor, that's not possible here. So you are limited on these predefined modules which are instrumented. And at this place, Inspected Ocelot comes into the game. So what is Inspected Ocelot? Like the OpenTelemetry Java agent, Inspected Ocelot is also a Java agent. It's a highly configurable Java agent which is not limited by collecting telemetry data, but it can actually collect any kinds of data, business data, runtime data, all which is accessible inside the JVM and by the application. This is done also by injecting OpenTelemetry bytecode, but the bytecode which is injected can be configured and changed at runtime during configurations. Like as OpenTelemetry, you don't have to do all by yourself. So this agent is coming with predefined configurations for also for popular libraries, frameworks. So if you have HTTP communication or JMS inside your Java application, this is gathered by default. So you don't have to do the same configuration over and over again, which is maybe already done by other people. And what we also have here, we call it some utility components. For example, in configuration server, these components can be used to manage the agents. So if we have multiple agents in multiple applications, for example, this configuration server can provide a centralized place for managing configurations, providing some managing view, seeing how many agents are out there, which agent versions are we using, or also which Java versions are used in the application where the agent is attached to. If we now attach this agent to the JVM, we get this basic visibility of our applications, like I said earlier. For example, HTTP requests, JMS, and so on. But if we want, for example, to extract now data from our custom class, from our application classes, which aren't a specific standard, we can do this, for example, using the configuration server. Here we have some simple UI where we can specify in a web interface which classes we want to trace, which method we want to measure. And maybe I don't have enough insight about my application, so I don't know exactly what full qualified name do I have to use or which method are provided there. We can also use something like, we call it a class browser, where the agent can provide information about its loaded classes, and then we have a list where we can scroll and search and easily click on certain methods we want to trace now. And using this information, this wizard is more or less autofilled, and in the end, we get a nice looking list which message will be instrumented by the agent. So in the end, these methods on this list, it's more or less as we would inject this OpenTelemetry code manually into them. But here it's done automatically, and we can do this or change this also at runtime without restarting the application. That's quite a basic tracing. That's more or less, in the end, we get execution times of methods. We see if there are exceptions occurring and so on. But if we want additional data, we have to dig deeper. So we have to use the advanced configuration of the agent, which is YAML-based. So for the people who don't like YAML, that's maybe not the correct tool. But in the end, this configuration consists out of three components. One component are the actions. Actions are more or less logic which can be defined and defines what the agent should be done. So it's more or less like a Java method in the end. Then we have something called scopes. Scopes represent a set of methods. And then we have the third part, rules. Rules splits the actions and scopes together and provides the actual call to action for the agent. So in the rule, you can state, okay, I want to trace all methods represented by a certain scope. And each time one of those methods start processing, I want to call a certain action for extracting data. For example, I want to gather some method arguments or runtime information of it. And in the end, this data which are collected by this action should be attached to a span or to a trace or exposed as a metric. So how does it look like? I have here a screenshot of such configuration. So at the top, we have our scope. In this case, we want to target, for example, a buy method of our exchange handler class. We have certain actions, and like you see, it's actually really Java code which can be defined here and which is then executed by the agent. And on the bottom, we have our rule, which where we can include predefined instruction set. For example, I want to trace all methods represented by scopes in this rule, so by this scope which I define here. And each time one of these methods are executed, I want to execute a certain action and store its result in a temporary variable, which is then, for example, added to our trace as an attribute. And then, and as a result, here we have a screenshot of Jaeger. So assuming we have the agent configured or OpenTelemetry, that it pushes its data to Jaeger. Now we get a span representing those methods and, for example, including the data which we have defined here using the actions. So that's basically how we can extract any kind of data and add it to our traces. The same can be done for metrics. So again, we have some scope. So we define some methods, some actions, some Java code here to extract data. And this time in our rule, we also specify a scope where something happens, so a certain set of methods. And each time one of them starts executing, we want to execute our actions to gather data. But this time, we don't want to add this data to a trace, but we want to export this as a metric value. So now, assuming, like I said earlier, we have here a lot of exporters available in OpenTelemetry. We can, for example, expose these collected metrics as a Prometheus endpoint, scraped by Prometheus, and then we would get this data which we extract here as a metric value. Okay. Now let's see this all in action. So for my demo, I prepared some small demo application. It's actually a Java application consisting of two Java processes, which represent some crypto exchange for handling Bitcoins, for example. So what we can do here is, let me send some HTTP requests to it. We can, for example, request that we want to buy a certain amount of Bitcoin, so we want to get a quote for it. And when we get a quote, we get some ID, and this quote can we then, it's a little bit small, can we accept and buy later on. I started this application without any agent. So first of all, we want to bring our agent in there. Like I said earlier, we can do this, for example, by the Java agent command from our JVM. But in this case, we don't want to do this. We can attach the agent during runtime. So this is done by calling the agent. The agent is also a Java archive and a jar file. The agent can just called as a normal Java application. So I prepared here a small script, which is done, is doing it for me. So we can call this application jar, providing a process ID and some configuration. For example, where is our configuration server, where it gets its configuration. And then the agent attaches itself to this JVM process and starts now monitoring it. So let's check our process. So we have this trading demo process here. And now we want to attach this agent to this 52542. So our agent is now attaching itself to this process ID. Now when we switch back to our initial application, we see here in the logs, suddenly there appeared this new logs from our agent stating, okay, it initialized itself, it's now there and collecting data. And by default, it's down here. By default, this agent also provides now a Promises endpoint for exposing metrics which is collected by it. So when we go back to Postman and executing, for example, a request against this predefined pod, for those of you who know Promises endpoints, actually you get now here a whole list of metrics which are exposed by the metric by the agent. So if we now request another quote because we want to buy some bitcoins, our agent is now or has instrumented our application with this predefined set of instructions. For example, I want to capture HTTP requests, JDBC calls, and so on. And I pre-configured the agent so that, for example, it uses Jaeger as a tracing backend here. So when we check out Jaeger now, we see we have here now a trace a few seconds ago. That's basically this request which I just executed. And now we see here, for example, we see the incoming HTTP request against this getQuote endpoint. Then it's doing some work. It is calling another Java process inside this trace. And in the end, it's doing some JDBC database call here. That's basically, I mean, it's a very simple application. And that's what you get out of the box. So you don't have to configure it. Now, if you have a look on the web UI, so that's basically the inspected configuration server where we can configure our agent. Its configuration is empty. And now we can say, okay, I have certain application logic which is critical for me because yeah, it's important and I have to provide data for reporting for it. I can just add, for example, classes and methods which are traced now. But like I said earlier, if maybe I don't know what is the class name exactly, then I can use here our class browser, select, for example, an agent, click on search, and now the agent provides which classes has been loaded by the JVM. So what is available inside this JVM and what could I instrument now? So I, in this list, that's basically all classes loaded by the agent, grouped by packages. So let me search for my demo trading package. And now I see I have my my application classes here. For example, I have this trading controller. And in this list, I see, okay, I have a certain method, for example, status or buy with specific arguments. And now I can just select them, press apply, save. And now the agent is instrumenting this method and adding the OpenTelemetry bytecode, which we manually add in our example in the first slide to it. So when we now send another quote against our application, let's check Jaeger. Here's our new trace. And now we have here this new span representing our quote method, which we just selected in the web UI. Have additional information about it. Information about, for example, the OpenTelemetry library which we're using here inside the agent. And that's basically this basic tracing. We get basic visibility of our application. I also prepared a little bit advanced configuration. So basically, that's a combination of these two YAML examples which I showed you in the presentation. So we have some scope representing a method. We define two actions, which I said are basically instruction Java code, which should be executed by the agent, and a rule stitching this all together. For example, on all methods of the scope, the agent should trace them. That's a predefined instruction set. And when one of those methods starts executing, we want to execute these actions. And the data which is generated by these actions should be added to the trace and at the same time exposed as a certain metric. So now we have this offer from our demo application. Let's take this ID and buy this stuff. So now we're executing this buy request, which is targeted by our application here. And let's go back to Jaeger. Now we see here our new trace against this buy endpoint. And this trace contains, for example, a span representing this buy method. And here we have our additional data which we added to our trace. In this case, we see, okay, the user bought some Bitcoin. And at the same time, if we check the Prometheus endpoint, we can see here, hey, it's a little bit small, but that this data is also now exposed as a metric. So there was one buy request and five of the type Bitcoin has been bought here. So we get actually, yeah, revenue metrics in near real time by this approach. Okay. If you want to see this in action in a real world usage, check out the talk by Sasha Brechmann tomorrow about open source application performance monitoring in enterprise. And if you have any questions, we have 1 minute left.